I began to compose at the same time where I learned to read music, around 10 years. It was very natural for me to write small melodies, like when you are learning to write, then you are writing small things about your life. And in doing that, of course, I just was writing for myself, or perhaps more precisely, I just wrote for the music. And this is perhaps the most important thing for me, that is to write for the music. But of course, I know also I get a commission by players, orchestras, ensemble. Then I know, of course, also that I write not just for the music, but also for the players and, of course, for the audience. But perhaps for them also it's the music that we are doing it for. For me, the musical language was perhaps the most precise for me. For me, to talk or to write is not perhaps as natural as sounds. For me, sounds has always, and music has always been more near to my, both my intellect and my emotions. A lot of my music has been inspired by seasons. For example, in my last piece of Schnee, that's inspired by actually snow, the snow as the element falling, but also as the snow landscape. For me, it's in a way, it's symbols. The stillness of the snow and the whiteness, and also the transition into before the spring, and it can be icy. All different kinds of pictures are important for me. In a piece like Winternacht, it's again the seasons, but here actually the first movement is winter, and then it goes backwards to autumn, and then to summer, and the last movement is spring. So coming from the first movement is actually going forwards from winter to spring. And that is always very been important for me, that somehow it seems that we go backwards, but actually we go forwards. It represents feelings of cold, warm, movement, growing, decay, all kinds of things that for me is in my music and has been there since I started writing.